मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर लिस्ट। लिस्ट आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन प्रोग्रामिंग एंड दिस इज अ सीक्वेंस। बेसिकली यू कैन से लाइक वी अर्लियर डिस्कस सीक्वेंस एंड वन सच सीक्वेंस वाज स्ट्रिंग। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर लिस्ट। Python sequence data types are ordered set of data type. Ordered set means not in alphabetical order or in ascending order or descending order something. Ordered set means the data are arranged according to their index. Okay, index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Each data is associated with the index like in a string. If there is a string Kendriya, then Kendriya K will be having index 0. So K, then E, then N. This is the order of the data in Kendriya string. So string is also a sequence. So Python sequence data types are ordered set of data. A sequence contains multiple data as elements, such as each element of a sequence is assigned with a number known as its index or position. Okay, an index starts with 0 here. So in which order the data appears, that is the basically order of data. Index of a sequence starts from 0 and increase by 1. The first index is 0 always, and then second will be 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, and so on. Okay, and we are having negative indexes also, negative indices also. Python sequence also supports negative indices, which starts from the last element and moves in backward direction. That is, the last element will have index 1, then second last will have minus 2, then minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, and so on. Okay, so the first element in this case will have the index as minus length of the object. Okay, we have gone through the len function, if you remember, len function, when we were talking about strings. Strings, list, tuple, range, we have discussed range also, we have discussed string also. List and tuple we are going to discuss now. So all these are basic Python sequences. There are total 6 basic Python sequences and 4 are in our syllabus. So Python list can be written as a list of comma separated values, items, elements, members between square brackets. Now what it means basically, remember the input function. We have used input function and it is used to read the string. It gives you a string, okay, like say name is equal to input, enter your name, right? So you will enter your name, say it could be anything, say Pawan, Kumar, Pandit. So this is the string. When you say name, it is a string. If you check the type of name, it gives you a string. Okay, now if suppose I use split function, we have discussed the split function also when we were talking about the string, say text is equal to input, enter some text dot split, and we want to split it on blank space. So say Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan. Now if I say text, what is text? So you can see what you are getting here. You see, just there are 3 strings. One is Kendriya, you can see this is the first string separated by comma, the second string Vidyalaya separated by comma, the third string Sangathan, and all the 3 strings are enclosed in square brackets. This is what I am talking about, square brackets. So this type of data is known as list. This type of data is known as list. Okay, so this is what you are getting here. If you see Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan, and this Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan is a list of strings. It is a list of string here. The data are string and this entire thing is referred as list. Okay, so Python list can be written as a list of comma separated values. You know, all the three things, Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan, they were separated by comma and they were written between square brackets. So that is called Python list. So what is a Python list? A Python list are ordered sequence, as I had told you, Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan. So the index of Kendri is 0, index of Vidyalaya is 1, index of Sangathan is 2. Or you can say index of Kendri is minus 3, index of Vidyalaya is minus 2 and index of Sangathan is minus 1 if we are talking about negative indices. Python list can have heterogeneous data type. Here in our example of list, we have all the elements, Kendri, Vidyalaya, Sangathan, all the three elements, they were of string data type, but that is not necessarily a restriction, because in Python list you can have different data types. So it is a heterogeneous data type, can be enclosed. Python lists are mutable, that is changeable. You can change the content of a Python list, that is not with the strings. If you remember, the strings are immutable. If say I am declaring a string, say s is equal to Kendriya, and then you say s0, what is s0? s0 is k, and you want to change k to say l, so that is not possible. But if you are working with the list and you want to change Kendriya, it is possible. Then Python list allows duplicate elements. It is not necessary that you have to work with the unique elements only. In Python list, you can have duplicate values. So this is your Python list. Like, this is just an example. Another example, say data is equal to start of a square bracket 103 comma Pavan comma M comma computer science comma 77.5. So this is what it is. Data is a list which consists of 5 different data. The first is roll number, the second is name, the third is gender, the fourth is subject, and fifth is the marks. So here you can see 103, it is an integer. Pavan M computer science, these are strings, and 77.5, that is a float. So this is how it is stored in a list. When a list is created, the data is stored like this. If you see, this is the data and these are the indexes. This is, you can see, these are the indexes, index 0, then index 1, 2, 3, 4, or you can see we are having negative indexes also in backward direction, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. So length of this particular list is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements are there. So length of this particular list is 5. So the index, negative index of a starting element is minus len, minus 5. Okay. So if you check the type of data, what is the data type of the variable data? So you will see it is a class list. Okay, class list. So it is a list, and if you print what is data, so you can see your data is 103 Pavan M computer science 77.5. So this is just a list. What is a list and how can we create list? There are various way of creating list. Okay, you can create a list from an empty list. You can create list from split also. We have just seen in an example. And you can create list with the use of list constructor also. Okay, so creating empty list, creation of empty list is very easy. List 1 is equal to simple square bracket, nothing. That is an empty list. If suppose I want to create an empty list, so what I will do, say L is equal to square bracket. This is an empty list. If I print it, I will get the empty list. Okay, so there is nothing special, and you can create an empty list, right? Then you can create a list from constructor also, like list 2 is equal to list. List is a constructor. So L1 is equal to list. So no argument is passed to the constructor. That means we are talking about empty list. Okay, so it will create empty list. if you see L1, it will create empty list. Or say suppose we want to create a list from a string, say the string is suppose Kendriya. This is a string and I want to create a list from this. It means K, E, N, D, R, I, Y, A. These letters will be part of the list. If you see L2, K, E, N, D, all are separate, different string. So it is used to convert a string to a list. You can use the same thing. Say, suppose I want to create a list from a tuple. Say, suppose I'm having a tuple 23, 25, 29. Suppose this is a tuple. A tuple is similar to list, but it is enclosed in brackets, group brackets. First thing. Second thing, tuples are immutable. Like lists are mutables, but tuples are immutable. So if I say this thing, list, and if we say L3, L3 is converted. L3 is a list. So tuple is converted to a list. So this is how you can work with. So you can use the constructor list from the other sequences. So list 3 is equal to list power. Okay. Now range also, range is also a sequence. So if suppose I say L4 is equal to list range, say suppose 5. So you know what range 5 will do? No? You remember na? What is the range function? Range 5 will do, it will generate integer between 0 to 5. It's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, but not 5. Not including 5. Okay, 0 to 5, but not including 5. So this is how the range. If I say L4, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is what is generated. So this is what we can create list. This is how we can create a list. Accessing list. How to access list? Once the list has been created, you can use it in your program. So a Python list can be accessed in the same function as a Python string. You have to use the list in same way as we have to work with the string. So what is exactly it means, like with the string? Say suppose if I'm creating a string, suppose S is equal to, again say, Kendri Vidyalaya. Okay. So now this string can be accessed in usually three ways, you can say. The first, I want to print the content of S, that gives me Kendri. I want to print the fourth character of the string. The fourth character of the string is S3, index starts from 0. So S3 is D. Okay, this is the fourth character, Kendri, K-E-N-D. Okay, or I want to access the string from fourth character to ninth character, not including ninth, slicing, remember slicing, so D-R-I-Y-A. So this is how we are accessing the string. The same, in the same fashion, we can access our list also. Now, just see, we are having a list L4. Okay, this is the L4 we have already created. L4, so if we say L4, it gives you 0, 1, 2, 3. This is, we are accessing the entire list altogether. Right? Then secondly, what I can do? Say, I want the third element of the list. So L4, third element, L4, 3. Okay, L4, 3. So what is the third element of the, fourth element, L4, 3 is fourth element, 0, 1, 2, 3. Third element, for third element we have to write L4, 2. This is the third element. So this is the third element of the list. And suppose if I want to print from first, second element to fourth element. So L4, second element, that is second element to fourth element. That is fourth element. But again, the case is same, not including the fourth element. Okay, so this is 1, 2, 3. So this is how you can access the Python list. Accessing individual list item, list name, and in the square bracket we have to provide the index. We can provide any type of index. We can use positive index, we can use negative index, any type of index is allowed. Like say, if say I'm saying him L4 minus 2, so minus 2 means 3.
the second last element. Minus 2 means second last element. So you can use positive index as well as negative index both. Or slicing, you can slice it like say list name from start to stop, not including stop and the step. Okay, just like we have discussed in this string. So to access list element from start to stop with the jump of step, okay, what we have to do, we have to use list name, square bracket, the start value, colon, the ending or stop value, colon, the jump step. Now the default value, start is by default 0, starts from the beginning. Stop is by default end, okay, including the end here. End means the last element, that is len plus 1, len plus 1, and step is by default 1. Okay, so this is how you can access the list. Say suppose I am creating a list here, again say L is equal to say 1, 11, 22, 99, hello, 121, okay, etc. Okay, this is the list I have created. So if I say L from third element, say 2, from third element, that is 2, up to fifth element. So up to fifth element, not including the fifth. So the address of fifth element will be 4. Address of fifth element will be 4. So this is what. Now if I say L colon 4, that is from the beginning. From the beginning. Starting is missing, from the beginning. And if I say L 4 colon, end is not mentioned. So up to the end. Okay, from the fourth element to end. Fourth element is your hello. 4 means, index 4 means the fifth element. Okay. So from this fifth element onwards. And we can use negative also. If I say hello, sorry, if I say L, say from minus 6, minus 6 to minus 2, not including minus 2, not including minus 2. So what is minus 6? This is, you can see minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, from 11 and up to minus 2, like this, not including minus 2. So minus 2 is 121, so not including it. So this is what it will generate. So this is, you can say, okay. And if we say L, say suppose minus 2 to minus 7, step minus 1, negative, it means reverse, backward direction, 121, then hello, then 99, then 22, then 11. So this is how you can access the list, slicing of the list, the same way like we have used in the strings. Unlike a string, Python list allows assignment operation. This is what, list are mutable. Say suppose I am creating a string. We have already created a string, if you remember, S is equal to Kendriya Vidyalaya. Okay, S is equal to Kendriya Vidyalaya. Now if I say S, say 0 is equal to small k, you will get the error. You will get the error because strings are immutable. You cannot do this thing. Okay, you get the clear message that str object does not support item assignment. But if suppose I have created a list of strings, okay, say this is you. Now if I say L 0 is equal to K, similarly L suppose 7, L 7 is equal to say V. Now print L, you can see small k, small v. So this is what, list are mutable. You can change the content of the list. Assignment operations are allowed onto the list, but the same thing cannot be done with the string. List operations, we are having various operations which are applicable to the list, like adding element to the list. There are various way to add element to the list. We can use append method, we can use extend method, we can use insert method, we can use plus method, and the multiplication method. So I will start from the easy one, like say from plus or from star. Now suppose I am having two list, L1 is equal to say 1, 2, 3, and L2 is equal to say 4, 5, 6. I want to add L1 is equal to L1 plus L2. I want to add L1 and L2 together, and I want to store the data into L1. That is possible. Okay. So what happens here? If it is possible, if now I say L1, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right? Similarly, if I say, L3 is equal to L1 into 3. Now, right now your L1 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 will be added 3 times and the data will be stored into L3. If you see L3, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, this is how you can add element to the list. Okay, what happens if you say L1 is equal to L1 plus 100? What it will do? It will generate error. It will generate error because you can add list, but you cannot add any other data type. Okay, this is not allowed. So this is you have to take care of when you are adding two lists or when you are using plus operation with the list, both should be the list only. Then we are having the append. Append adds an item at the end of a list. Say again, I am saying L1 is equal to suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, now at the end I want to add 7. So what I will do, L1 dot append say 7. 7 will be added at the end of the list. You can see 7 has been added. Then say L1 dot append say suppose 8. It has been added. But here I cannot add two items together. Suppose I want to add 9 and 10, and if I say L1 dot append 9 comma 10, it will generate error. Okay, this will generate error because the function append takes only one argument. But I can convert it into one argument like this: append L1 dot append say I want to add two things, 9 and 10. So I had converted 9 and 10 into a list, and I can add now to the list. But if I print L, you can see this 9 and 10, this is not just two different items. This is just one object, one item. So this is what we are trying to say here: list append item. We can add just one item at the end of the list. Okay, if you want to add more than one item, then you have to use extend. Okay, so how, say suppose now I'm creating L2. L2 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can check the list L2. Has been created, and now what I want to do, I want to add 7 into it. So I will say L2 dot extend say 7. Error. You got the error. Why you got the error? Because if you see the syntax, iterable sequence, you have to provide a sequence. Okay, so what I will say, L2 dot extend say 7. Now this is a sequence. Okay, L2 dot extend 8, or L2 dot extend 8 9. I have added 8 two times. It doesn't matter, the two element have been added together, and you can see this is not just one element. Like here in L1, when we appended, it has been added like one element, but here it has been added like two different elements. So this is how you can use extend. So the difference between the append and extend is very much clear. Append adds only one item, whereas extend adds multiple item. In append you can provide an item, and in extend you have to provide an iterable sequence. Okay, both ends the list at the end, item will be added at the end of the list. Then we are having insert. You can specify the position where you want to add the item, like l1 dot insert. In l1 I want to add on fifth position a value 999. Okay, now if we say l1, you can see 999 has been added at which position? 999 has been added at fifth position, 0 1 2 3 4, and then 5. Clear? So similarly, say l2 dot insert, say at seventh position we want to add hello. Okay, so this is, so you can specify the object. Say if we say l2 dot insert, say same at seventh position, I want to add say 11 22 33, a list here. So if you see l2, you can see this is just one element, one object. This is just one object, insert. So in insert also you are entering only one item, only one object. So this item and this object, both are almost same, you can say. Okay, so this is how you can add element to a list. There are 5 different methods and we have discussed them, and hope you will got my point. Now removing elements from the list, like you add elements to the list, similarly you can remove the element from the list. So to remove element from the list you have 2 methods, one is remove, another is pop. Then we are having clear also. So remove, pop, clear, and there is a 4th method that is called tell. Okay, removes the very first occurrence of the first item. Very first occurrence of the item. See, if I am having a list of say 10 numbers and I say dot remove 5, so it means the first 5 will be first element number 5. Okay, first element will be removed whose value is 5. Say l is equal to, suppose 1 2 3 4 5 1 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, this is a list, this is a list. If I say l dot remove, if I say l dot remove, it will remove the element you want to remove. Suppose I want to remove 5, so first occurrence of 5 will be removed. The first occurrence of 5, 1 2 3 4 5, that is the first occurrence. The second 5 is the second occurrence. Okay, so if you say l, the first occurrence, now it is 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 5, the 5 in between 4 and 1 has been removed. But if you are trying to remove something which is not in the list, it will generate error. If I say l dot remove, suppose now 5, it means now it will remove the first occurrence. So now at the end you are having a 5 in the list, that will be removed. You see, 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. But if I say again, if l dot remove, if the same statement I issue again, what happens? You got the error. If the element does not exist, the element you are trying to remove does not exist, it will generate the error, right? Then we are having pop. What is the difference between remove and pop? In remove we specify the element we want to remove, but in pop we specify the index of the element. Like now my list is 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. Okay, say let's make it as it is, as it was earlier, L dot insert. Remember the insert we have discussed? At fifth position I want to insert 5.
Very good.
At sixth position it has been added, and doesn't matter. Then at the last position, L, at the last position, just before last, we have added. So this is how we inserted a 5 into the list. Now again I want to remove it. So L dot, now this time I am using pop. So what I want to pop? I want to pop the sixth element. Here the 5 is sixth element now. So the index of sixth element is 5. So pop 5. It returns you the element which has been popped, which has been removed. The 5 has been removed. Now I want to delete another 5. So I would say L dot pop, and the index of the next 5, the index of 5 is this time is -2. So L dot pop -2, and it says 5 again. 5 again means 5 has been popped. The element 5 has been popped. Check, the 5 has been removed again. So you can specify the index and you can remove it. Okay, what happens if you give an index which is not existing? Say if I say L dot pop say 20, index 20 does not exist here, it will generate an error, index out of range. You will get the error, index out of range. Okay, and if we are not providing index, yeah, we can write pop like this also. If we are not providing index, then it removes always the last item. The last item is your 4. So L dot pop 4. 4 has been popped. Yeah. So this L dot pop without any argument, it is very helpful, very important, you can say, when you are working with the stack. No, you know what is the stack? The stack is last in, first out. The element which is at last is out first. So if you want to create a stack, then you will be using append and pop function. Why append and pop? Because append add an element at the end, you know very well, add an element at the end, and pop removes an element from the end if the index is not provided. So this is what the remove and pop function. Okay, what happens if we say clear? Suppose I say clear, L dot clear. It clears the list. Clears the list means deletes all the element of the list and makes the list empty. It makes the list empty, but list still exists. You can see list still exists. If you add L dot append 1, it will work. L dot append 2, it will work. List exists, right? So this is the third, L dot clear. And what L dot clear will do? It will clear all the data from the list, but list will exist. Okay, then the finally we are having a del command, delete command. Del command is used to delete element from the list. So you can use, say, suppose first we create the list. Let's say create a list. L is equal to say this time I'm using 9 8 7 6 5 4 3 2 1, a reverse order list. So this is, now I want to delete 6. Now 6 is the fourth element. Okay, so what I will say, del from the list fourth element, L3. I want to delete L3. You check, 6 has been deleted. You can see there is no 6 in between 7 and 5, right? We can provide slicing also. Like say I want to delete from 5 to, I want to delete 7, 5, 4. So I will say del from the list. Now 7 is your element index 2, 0 1 2 okay 2 from 2 to 4 so 2 3 4 5 2 colon 5 but not including 5 right so this is deleted if you check L you can see 7 5 4 has been deleted from index position 2 to index position 5 but not including 5 so 7 5 4 has been deleted or you can simply say del L it will delete the entire list will delete the entire list but it is not similar to clear clear also deletes the entire list but only the content of the list is deleted list exist empty list exist but here list does not exist try to print it L it will give you error there is nothing like L try to say L dot append it will generate error because there is nothing L so this is what the difference between the clear and del command right so you know we have created l2 list l2 also and suppose we want to delete so l2 and if I say this what will it will do from beginning to end every data will be deleted from beginning to end every data will be deleted but l2 exist remember this is what this statement l del with a colon this statement is equivalent to the clear function or you can perform the same thing like this also remember we have l3 also so if I say pop sorry l3 so this is how you can use the removal operation you can remove the elements from the list then copying a list we can perform copy operation onto the list a list can be assigned to another list so we have two different methods one is list dot copy it returns a shallow copy of the list you know remember this word shallow copy means copying the data byte by byte bit by bit okay there will be no difference between the two copies though they will be available at different memory locations but there will be no difference between the two copies so with the help of copy function we can create duplicate of a list and with the constructor also we can create the copy like suppose l is equal to 1 2 3 4 and if I say a is equal to l dot copy so a and l both are same a is l false because both are using different memory location but if check is a equal to l it will be true because a and l both are same right a is not l a is different l is different because both are using different memory locations but they are same okay and there is another way also suppose I want to create a copy so I can say list l this is also a way of creating a copy now b is l the answer is still false but b is equal to a true is b equal to l true so this is how you can use the copy and list okay then we are having ordering some other operations like ordering list you can order a list using short function and reverse function short function basically arrange it in alphabetical order or ascending order or descending order something like that but reverse function is basically to reverse the element its in its place so short method it have two arguments and both have default value like key is equal to none key is equal to none and reverse is equal to false okay now what is the meaning of key is equal to none or what is the meaning of false So for this, I'm creating a list. Say L is equal to, say, list. Suppose ten. This is a list. Like now, if I say L dot short, it will be simply sorted according to the ASCII code. If you say L, now K, K is capital letter, so capital letter comes before small letter, so K, and then the A which is at the end moves to the second place, then D, then E, I, N, R, Y, you know, this is in alphabetical order. At the same time, if I say, suppose again I am creating the list, say this time suppose M, M is Kendri. If I say M dot short, and I want to short, say reverse is equal to true. Default is false. It means it will not be in descending order. But here, if I say reverse is equal to true, so that means I want in reverse order. Reverse order means Y will be on top and K will be at the bottom. Okay. So if you say M. So you can see here, this particular order is ascending and this particular order is descending. That is the difference between the two orders. Okay. So now take another example. Say I am having list of students. Say L is equal to, suppose, Pavan, Manmeet, Ashrika and Rishita. Okay. If I say L dot short, of course Ashrika will be first, Manmeet will be second, Pawan will be third, and Rishita will be the fourth. You can check it. This is your ascending order. If I say reverse is equal to true, that means it will be in reverse direction, in descending order. Now if say some of the text I make capital, now again I am creating another list, say M, and in this list say Pawan, P is capital, and at the same time Rishita, R is capital. You can see M. Now if I say M dot short, what happened? The first name will be Pawan, second name will be Rishita, third name will be Ashrika, third, fourth name will be Manmeet. Why? P and capital R, capital P and capital R, they comes first in ASCII code and small letters comes after the capital letters. So it will be after. So if you see, this is what you are. But say I want to ignore this thing. So here the role of key is, you can specify the key. How? Say again create the same thing. Say this is M, I am creating same thing. You can check it. Okay. Now what I say, M dot short. M dot short. And key. Key is equal to str dot lower. Key is equal to str dot lower. And leave it str dot lower. That means whatever data is, I want to convert the data into lowercase, and when it is converted into the lowercase, then only shorting will be performed. So now if you see what the result is, Ashrika first, Manmeet second, Pawan with capital P third, and Rishita with capital R fourth. Why? Because at the time of comparing them to find their appropriate position, the data Pawan and Rishita has been converted into lowercase and then it has been shorted. So this is how you can use the short function. And reverse does not short. Again take the example, say M is equal to, rather say L is equal to list Kendri. Okay, if I say L dot reverse, what happened?
the Kendriya word will be reversed. Okay. A, then Y, then I, R, N, D, N, E, K. Okay. It is similar to what? It is similar to backward tracing. Backward tracing. Okay. L dot reverse is equal to what? L dot reverse is equal to, if I say L, it will be printing Kendri. If I say L, say from the end, like this, from the end to the beginning in reverse direction. This is reverse. Clear? Like this. Any of the notation you can use. String slicing, we have already discussed this particular thing. Okay. So here, so this is also the same thing. So this is how you can calculate the shorted list and reverse list. List. There are some other operations also which can be performed onto the list. Some of the operation, like one is, one such operation is count. Count is a method. Okay. So count item. Count item. It simply counts the item. How many times? The frequency of the item, you can say. Frequency of the item. Okay. Say, suppose, just take the same example. Say L, we have already created. The list is Kendriya. And I want to find, say, just take another example. L is equal to, say, list of, suppose, K E N D R I Y A V I D Y A L A Y A. Now, if I say L, this is Kendri Vidyalaya. Okay. Now, if I say L dot count, what exactly I want to count? Say, suppose I want to count D. How many times the D has been occurred in the list? So, it will be two times. Once in Kendri and another in there. Similarly, if I say L dot count, say A, so it will be many times, four times. Okay, so this is how you can use count function. How many times it has been? If it is not available, then what happens? Say, if I say L dot count, say Z, of course Z is not in Kendri Vidyalaya, so it will say zero. Okay, so count is just to count the number of items, number of times the item appears into the list. And then list dot index item start end, we are searching. This is search function. Basically, we are looking for the item, first occurrence of the item within the range start to end, not including end. Not including end, that is optional item. If you are not providing, it will search the things into the entire data. You can see here, say if I say L dot index, say I want to search A, so it will give me first occurrence of A. First occurrence of A is 7, the index position 7, our 8th character. Okay, so index position 7. But if I perform the same thing, L dot index, I want to search it from 7th position. Start is 7th, at 7, suppose from 8th position, so the 12. It means from the 8th position, from the 8th position, the A is available at index position 12, right? And further we say L dot index, say A, from 8th to, say 12, 8 to 12, not including 12, 8 to 12, so answer will be error. Why error? It is not in the list. So index functions returns you an error if the element is not present. Okay, so this is how you can search the data within the list. Then len function, it simply gives you the length of this data, length of the list, that is number of elements in the list. Len L,
17. In Kendriya Vidyalaya, there are total 17 letters. And then we are having sum, min, max. Okay. Like say, suppose if I say min L, it gives you the minimum element. So minimum element is capital K, alphabetical order. Okay. Here. Or if we say max L. So max L will be Y. Max L will be Y, small y. Okay. Similarly, if suppose I am creating a list of numbers, say 1, 3, 2, 5, 4, 9, 6, minus 1, minus 22, or say minus 1, that is sufficient. Suppose this one, this is a list, and if I say min L, it will be max L, it will be 9. Say sum of L, it will be sum all the elements. So this is, you can use len, sum, min, max function. Then we are having membership functions, membership methods. Remember in we have used. So in and not in operator can be used, and there are two way. One is membership test and another in iteration, like item in list. Say this is your list L, 1, 2, 3, 4, and if I say, suppose I want to check, what I want to check, okay, whether my list contains 6 or not. So 6 in L, true, 6 is available. Or say I say, 22 in L, that is false. And we can use like for, say I in L, print I. So I in L, it means iteration. We want to access element one by one. 1, 3, 2, 5, 4, 9, 6, minus 1. So in first case, I will be 1, then it will be 3, then it will be 2, then it will be 5. Individual elements of the list. Okay. So this is 1, 3, 2, 5, 4, 9, 6, minus 1. So this is, we can use the list is equal to computer. So if C in list, answer will be present, else absent. So what is your answer? Your answer will be absent, of course. It will be absent because small c is not present in the list. Okay. Similarly, for x in list, print x dot upper. X dot upper is c, capital C will remain capital C, small o becomes capital O, small m becomes capital M, and so on. And as an end, we have used a space, so there is a gap between each character. Okay. Comparison. We can compare two lists. And when you are comparing the list, the comparison goes element by element. First element is compared with the first element, second element is compared with the second element, third element is compared with the third element, and so on, till either the condition fails or all the element has been compared. Okay. So Python allows compare two lists with the use of relative operations, operators with less than equal to, greater than equal to, and not equal to. Python compares list elements of both the list one by one, that is element at a particular index in first list is compared with the element at same index in the another list. If both the elements satisfy the requested comparison, then the next element of both the list get compared, and the process is repeated till the end of the list or to the element where comparison fails. Okay. So like this, you say first list is 139 and second list is 1212, and we are comparing list 1 is greater than list 2, so answer is 2, true. Why true? Because 1 is equal to 1 and 3 is greater than 2. Since 3 is greater than 2, second element is greater than the second element of the next list, that's why it is true. Okay. Similarly, 139 is equal to 1312, answer is false because third element is not equal to the third element of second list. Similarly, 139 is greater than 1,8, true, because false, because first element is greater than first element is equal to first element, and second element of another list, no, so the result is false. So this is how comparison goes. And then we are having very 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 important topic, list comprehension. Okay. List comprehension is a smart programming. Most of the time we use list comprehension for smart programming. List comprehension is a concise way of creating list. Now suppose we want to create
a table, table of 5 or table of 10. So this is the program, you can say, n is equal to in input enter a number. By this statement we will ask a number. We created an empty table, empty list. This is an empty list we have created. Okay, tables 1 is equal to for x in range 1 to 11. We want to, for table we want 1 jar, 2 jar, 3 jar, 4 jar, and so on. So 1 to 10. So for x in range 1 to 10, table 1 dot append. In the list at the end we want to add what? N into x. N is the number. Say suppose you want to generate a table of 5. So suppose n is equal to 5, you want to perform table of 5. So 5 into x will be 1, 5 into 1, 5 into 2, 5 into 3, 5 into 4, 5 into 5. That will be added to the list, and finally your result will be like this. Okay, it will depend upon n. If your input here, this example is, if your input is 5, then this table will be generated. So this is just a complete program. But if the same thing you want to do in another way, in concise way, then how you can do? This is one way. We are creating a list, and in the list we are using the lambda function, map lambda x n into x. And what is the value of x? The value of x will be range 1 to 11. So it will be automatically, it will automatically create this because our n is 5. Okay, we have already taken n as 5. So this is the table will be there. And there is another method also. There is one more easier method also. This is, you can see, table 3 is equal to the list symbol, list n into x for x in range 1 to 11. So this is far easier. For x in range, you know very well what it will do. For x in range 1 to 11, for x in range 1 to 11, what exactly we want to perform? n into x. So this will create the same table. So this particular statement, this is basically, this particular statement, you can say, this is called the list comprehension. Okay, in a concise way you can create a job. Now the following examples have been taken from the official Python site, and we acknowledge the copyright of docs.python.org. So these are the examples which I have took from the original Python site, and since these examples are very good and there are slight modifications for the understanding of the student level, so accordingly you can go through. Say this is what we are doing: x comma y for x in 1 2, for y in 3 1 4. We want to create a pair of x and y. So what will be, x is 1, then y will be 3 1 4, that is 1 3 1 1 1 4. And when y will be 2, oh sorry, x will be 2, it will be 2 3 2 1 2 4. So if you are performing this thing, this is the result we are getting. X is 1, you can see, and y is 3 1 4. Then x is 2, y is 3 1 4. Similarly, we are having x comma y for x in 1 comma 2, for y in 3 comma 1 comma 4, if x is not equal to y. Here, this is the same statement. Up to this portion, this is the same statement. But the condition implies, that what is the completion condition? X should not be equal to y. So this is where x is equal to y. So this will fail. So the result will be 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 4. You can see 1 3 1 4 2 3 2 1 2 4. Then vector is equal to, suppose this is a list, -4 -2 0 2 4, and we want only the positive values. So x for x in vector, we want the value of x for x in vector, individual value. So okay, if I issue this statement only, it will print the same list, but I want only the positive values which are greater than 0. Okay, so if x is greater than equal to 0, so if this will give me 0 2 4, right? Similarly, I am saying apps x for x in vector. So apps x, -4 becomes 4 -2 becomes 2, 0 will remain 0, 2 will remain 2, 4 will remain 4. Absolute values, my negative becomes positive. Okay, similarly x comma x to the power 2, we are calculating the power here. For x in range 6, that means 0 to 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So x will be 0, 0 to the power 2, x will be 1, 1 to the power 2, and so on. So you can say 0, 1 to the power 2, 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 4 square, and then 5 square. Similarly, if vector is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, we want to flatten it. Flatten it means it is something like that 3 into 3 matrix, 3 into 3 array, but we want to convert it into array, one dimensional array. So we are saying num for element in vector. Now just go through this thing. For element in vector, for element in vector, this is your vector, and what will be the element? This is element in first iteration, this is element in second iteration, this is element in third iteration. Okay, so take the first iteration, the element is 1 2 3, then it will execute. For num in element, so this num is this num, and what is element? Your element is this one, 1 2 3. So when this iteration will go, first it will be 1, num will be 1, then num will be 2, then num will be 3, and it will be added to a list, first 1, then 2, then 3. Then next element will be picked, and 4, 5, 6. Then next element will be picked, 7, 8, 9. And in this way, you will get this type. Okay. This is, you can see, 1, 2, 3, then 4 will be added, 5 will be added, 6 will be added, then 7 will be added, then 8 will be added, and then 9 will be added. This is, you can say, nested for. We are using nested for. Say, this is just also one of the very good example. Fresh fruit is having banana. You see the blank spaces, extra blank spaces we are having here. Long berry, these are the extra blank spaces, and passion fruit, this is the extra blank spaces. So we have already used the word, you know, strip to remove the excess blank space. Okay, so we are using the strip here to remove excess blank space from the left, from the right, that is leading, trailing, and leading, trailing. Okay, but not from the middle. So we are saying fruits dot strip for fruits in fresh fruits. Fruits, so first fruits will be banana and it will be stripped, then long berry it will be stripped, and then passion fruit it will be stripped. So result will be banana without excess blank space, long berry without excess blank space, passion fruit without any excess blank space. You can see you are not having blank spaces here. Okay, you can see here you are having excess blank space, but here you are not having any excess blank space. Similarly, say suppose we want to round off pi, so we are having a math library, so we are using from math import pi. Now the pi is having its own value 3.1427 and something like that. So we want to do rounded it to the ith place, ith decimal place. So I value of I is 1 to 6. It means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 5 decimal places. So this is 1 place of decimal sign, 2 place of decimal sign, 3 place of decimal sign, 4 place of decimal sign, and finally 5 place of decimal sign. So you can see, say at the 5th place 9, so it becomes 6. At the 4th place 6, so it becomes 2, 1 becomes 2. Okay, but here it will remain 3.14 because it is 2, and here it will remain 3.1 because it is 4, and so on. So say this is a matrix. Okay, you can see it is a 3 into 4, 3 rows are there. This is first row, this is second row, this is third row, and each row contains 4 element, that is 4 columns. So this is 3 into 4 matrix, and we want to transpose, we want to calculate the transpose. Okay, so this is how we are calculating the transpose. Row I for row in matrix. Okay, for row in matrix, now see, for row in matrix, this is your matrix, complete matrix, this is your complete matrix, and for row, so this will be the first row, then this will be the second row, and this will be the third row. So when the first row is selected, loop will be executed 4 times, range 4, 0, 1, 2, 3. So when it is 0, I is 0, row 0, this is 0. Okay, then row will be this one, I is still 0,
5. Then rho will be this one and I still 0, 9. So it will give you 1, 5, 9. Then I becomes 1. When I becomes 1, again, this will be your rho and rho 1. This is 2, 6, 10 and so on. It will be added again and again. Where? In a two-dimensional array, you know, into a list. If I remove this particular square bracket, then it is flattening the two-dimensional matrix. But since I am having two, this is two-dimensional, so the result will be like this. This is the first row, this is the second row, this is the third row, and this is the fourth row. So the column has been converted to row and row has been converted to the column. This is your transpose matrix. So we have created transpose. The same thing if you are performing with the help of for loop, then this is how you created a transpose matrix and then you append like this. So this is your transpose. And what you are appending, you can see very clearly. What you are appending. If I remove this square bracket, suppose, what happens? It will be just a one-dimensional array. But since I am appending a list into a list, it will be a two-dimensional array, or you can say a two-dimensional list. So this is what the list is. Lot many things we have discussed. Some very good programs, you try to do it. If you are able to do this thing, you will be master of list, I'm sure. So these are the programs. Write a Python program to find the largest string in the list. You have a list of strings and you have to find the largest string. On the basis of length, you can calculate, or in ascending order, but on the basis of length, okay. Largest string on the basis of length, okay. Make it clear. So write a Python program to find the indices of minimum element in the list of integers. You have a list of numbers and you have to find which element is minimum and what is its indices. Say maybe there are multiple minimum elements. Say suppose element, there is a value 3 which appears 4 times into the list at different places and it is minimum. So all those indices you have to give. Write a Python program to create a list of integers using list comprehension method. Okay, create a list of integers using list comprehension method. Simply write a program. How you can create? See, input function you will use, you will split them and you will use list comprehension. Write a Python program to check whether a list is empty or not. Okay, whether the list is empty or not. So same is function. We have already discussed is function. So we will use this function. Write a Python program to print permutation of all the elements in the list. So okay, like the list is, list 1 is having 123. So all combination of 123, like first combination is 1, 2, 3, then 1, 3, 2, then 2, 1, 3, then 2, 3, 1, then 3, 1, 2, then 3, 2, 1, and so on. All possible combination of these things. Write a Python program to convert a list of characters into a string. Okay, you are having list of characters, very multiple characters are there and you want to convert them into a string. Okay, write a Python program to find some minimum and maximum of all the integer items in a list. You have just gone through, you have to find the sum, minimum and maximum. So try attempting these questions, and in case of any problem, please feel free to contact. So next we will start with the tuple once list will be completed.